Welcome to this third round of the Steelbourne Royale faction game. Sorry for the slight technical issues, but they should be fixed. This week, however, only five of the factions actually have orders for me. Our church, they are busy doing church things. I also noticed a few mistakes on the faction sheet. I forgot to send the invoice to the church for their base of influence. So their balance is actually just 9, because they bought a base of influence for 6 credits. For the Enigma entertainment, there had also snuck in a small error. Probably somewhere in my head I counted wrong, so they should only have 15 fact credits. And with those two things handled, it is time to go to the orders. This week we begin with the Bountiful Trader Conglomerate, continuing on to the Helix Foundation. After that it's the Enigma Entertainment. Followed by, not the church, they aren't followed by the church, but by the East Space Company. And finally, the pirates get to do piratey things. So with no further ado, let's get busy. So, the Bountiful Trade Conglomerate. As always, very well formatted order. So, their goal, Peaceable Kingdom, will be updated. Alright, it was Control Enter. Which they now have done for 3 turns. Now then, their asset ability. They want to use the Venture Capital and their Commodities Broker. No, not that one. This one. The game without any form of nice graphics. So, where were we? Yes. They are going to use their venture capital by rolling a d8, so let's do that. Let's not hope for one. Really nice, an 8. That should keep them slightly swimming in cash. That 8 will grant them 3 fact credits. Bountiful Trade Conglomerate. So they now have 9 credits. And then they are going to use their 2 commodities brokers. That is two d8s again. Two fours. Which means that their next purchase will be reduced by 8 fac credits, maximum down to half their maximum. Church had nothing. So second faction is the Helix Foundation. And the Helix Foundation doesn't have any goal since they achieved it last time. So their new goal is to expand influence. Now, how do they want to do that? They want to use their shipping combine to move their party machine. And then they want to use their post-tech industry. So let's make sure that that we don't misremember their shipping combine, which, if I remember correctly, is a wealth asset. Yes. Transport large amounts of equipment and personnel between worlds. As an action, the Combine may move any number of non-force assets, including itself, to any world within 2 hexes, at the cost of 1 fac cred per asset. So, they want to move their party machine that is on Turid, HF0004. It is on a Turid. They want to move that to Halger 0303. So let's see where Halger is. Oh, it's up here. And Halger is a planet tech level 3. It's not the most well-developed planet. Perhaps because it's a police state, stifling innovation and free thought, exchange of information, and they are xenophiles as well. So let's make that public, and then let's color it. Helix Foundation asset, and then we're going to mark it as a non-base of influence asset. So Party machine to Halger, 0303. That is moved, and let's remove 1 credit from them. The second part of their action was to use their post-tech industry on Furid. So, post-tech industry, if I remember correctly as well, should be a wealth asset. Post-tech industry. As an action, donating faction can roll d6. 1 effect credit is lost, and the higher Demar Facreds are being generated. So let's roll that d6. The payout is great this round for the credit generating assets. So Postic Industry, mark a 6 on that, and we should also mark the venture capital with an 8. Yeah, so that it is being remembered. And the 6 on the Facred on the Postic Industry generates 2 Facreds. So then that covered for the cost of shipping things around. Helix Foundation, new goal, and just some assets. Party machine moved, and Postic Industry used. And number 3. Oh yeah, and the Helix Foundation also wants to change their color. So, and time to see what their alternative color should be. I'm thinking needs to be a bit brighter, so that one perhaps. Yeah, that looks decent enough. And so for the faction I've been having wrongly entered, I had it Enigma Entertainment instead of Enigma Entertainment, but that is changed. Their action is to use some asset abilities. So this looks like they want to use their commodities broker E0001. Let's just, yep, there it is, the commodities broker. Let's roll that d8, a 6. Good amount of a discount. I'm putting it there. So then they want to move their party machine from Turon to Esinis using their mercenary movement. So let's take a look at what the mercenary movement is. Mercenary group. All faction assets gains the following special ability. As an action, the asset may move itself to any world within one hex. Kind of nice. So, and let's see. The party machine that was purchased the last round wants to be moved from 0203. Let's just verify that it is on 0203 Torun. Yes. To be moved to Essis. From 0203 to 0102. And there it is. It's another tech level 3 world. Not exactly the most organized bunch. A bunch of anarchists. And then there is a sealed menace on the planet. Something on this planet has the potential to create enormous havoc for the inhabitants if it's not kept safely contained by its keepers. Great world to start developing. So I need to create an alternative Enigma Entertainment color. This will be a bit of a darker one. So, and we're going to paint it up there, and give it a nice little shade. So, part machine 0201 to Essis. Essis. And that is that done. And there are no unstealthed enemies with an attack rating in a Tauron, you cautious one. And that was it all for Enigma Entertainment. Yeah, and then it should have been the church, but I got no orders, so it's East Space Company instead. Yeah, and the East Space Company, last round, achieved their goal, so... They are setting a new goal, planetary seizure. So let's copy that part. So, planetary seizure takes a total of three rounds once it's started. However, the space company isn't starting it this round because that requires a special action. And that action, well, let's bring it up. Faction goal. Planetary seizure. Take control of a planet, becoming the legitimate planetary government. And then they will have to take the... Let's see... There it is. Seize planet action. The faction seeks to become the ruling body of a world, must destroy all unstealthed assets. Once all resistance has been crushed, the attacker must maintain at least one unstealthed asset on the world for 3 turns. So... And also let's take... E-Space Company wants to become the planetary governor of Saliquan. First, first step is to seize the planet, and that requires them to remove all opposition. Let's see, Salikwan. And that, what do we see here? Well, the only faction with assets on Salikwan is the East Space Company, and they are all stealthed. So either East Space Company would have to unstealth something, or buy something unstealthed. East Space Company, their tag is secretive. And this means that all their assets they purchase begins stealthed. And instead of unstealthing something, they are buying a false front on Salikwan. False front should be a cunning. Yes, this asset allows the faction to preserve more valuable resources. If another asset on the planet suffers enough damage to destroy it, the faction can sacrifice the false front instead to nullify the killing blow. False front, it's cunning one. It costs one fact credit. So let's see, does the space company have one credit? They have seven credits. Correction, they have six credits and a false front. So space company, false front, and Salikwan. The ES-03-01. So and this asset was explicitly purchased as not stealthed. So not grayed out. And that is all for the East Space Company. I have a feeling their next action will be Seas planet. But that is for next round. And last but not least, the Flaming Dragon. Their action is to use asset ability to move to their blockade fleets. So 0404 to 0504 and 0406 to 0505. So let's see. The one on, how did I write this? Oh yeah, I should. 0504 moves to 0404, not the other way around. So 0504, that one moves from 0504 to 0404. Nice shading there. And the 0504 moves to 0406. Moves over there. And I have a feeling some color have been changed here. Well, I'll have to look up that shading later. So, the Bountiful Trade Conglomerate have some Flaming Dragon assets on their turf. So, however, there is a few small things we really need to have a look at. Faction tags. No. The Bountiful Trade Conglomerate is not planetary government, so they cannot deny the pirates. Entrance into their system or in orbit around their main planet. How fun. So let's update their locations. The 0504 moves to 0404 Kalia. And the 0505 moves to 0406. Which one? Add Medis. So, as usual, let's take a look at the Add Medis. It's a tech level 4 plus planet. So it follows the same rules as a regular tech level 4 planets, but they got some more advanced things. Oh, their population is alien. Their tags are Beastmasters. The natives have extremely close bonds with the local fauna, possibly having special means of communication and control through tech or engineering. Hippies. And there was a terraform failure. Was marginal for human habitation when it was discovered, but the mandate of early government put in pre-tech terraforming engines to correct its more extreme qualities. The terraforming did not entirely work. So the population, they aren't human, they are aliens. And they have very close bonds with the local fauna, possibly due to this terraforming failure. Is it a planet of furries? It may be a planet of furries. And then those two were updated. Need to advance their goal. Which is completed. The Flaming Dragon had completely seized their home planet of Ingiger. It is now firmly under the control of the pirates. Perhaps not for the casual observer, but somehow the pirates control it all. So, this means that they gain the planetary governor tag for a foreign gear. So let's make a little note of that. And the goal is achieved. So how much XP do they get from the planetary seizure? If the planet somehow lacks any opposing faction to resist the seizure, it counts as difficulty 1. So they get 1 experience as well, putting a number on the scoreboard. So let's empty the goal. And I had moved the blockade fleets. Great. So hopefully next round we'll see some shots fired, because that's what you do with your blockade fleets. So, and the blockade fleets, they use their force to attack, and the defender uses their wealth to attack, to defend. Yeah, and it's a D10 plus their force rating. Yeah, and the D10 plus their wealth rating. So the Flaming Dragon would add a 6 to their roll, and if they are attacking the Bountiful Trade Conglomerate, oh, it would be an even. A bit of a risky maneuver. The blockade fleets, they also have this little nice ability. When they successfully attack an enemy faction asset, they steal 1d4 fact creds from the target faction as well. And with all orders done, there is nothing left to do but for me to press a button. Payout faction incomes. And we see some are getting very rich. Enigma Entertainment, Flaming Dragon, and Helix Foundation. And so, that would be all for this round. And as usual, I want the next round's orders Saturday morning, 6 a.m. UTC. That would be the 21st of July, 6 a.m. UTC. So thank you for stopping by, and this is it for this week. Let's hope for a explosive round next turn. Good night.